Hi guys, George Ray here. Just going through my tackle bag, just having a sort through, see what I need and what I don't need for my next trip. All this stuff come out of that bag. What we got here, I'll go through a few bits of you. Dissolvable foam, that's really good. You put it on your hook when you're casting far distances. Then you know your hook isn't tangled up in weed, because what that does is sinks down to the bottom, then it dissolves, exposing the hook, so you know your hook isn't tangled in weeds and everything's safe. Dissolvable bags, exactly the same thing. You fill them up with pellets or boilies and you can chuck them out a long way and you know they're going to dissolve, so you can get really tiny baits out far distances. In here we've got some weights and stuff. You don't need massive big weights. I think the biggest weight I ever use is probably a 5 ounce, maybe 6 sometimes, no higher than that, but most of them I would say 3-4 ounces, 2 ounces, that's fine. For the summer, jungle formula. And there's a net there as well, in case it gets really bad. You can just stick that net over your head, keep them mozzies off you. This is my favourite box, my feeder box. Got lots of feeders in here, all different sizes. Some have got elastics in them. They are good because you can get lots and lots of tiny baits out a long distances. That is what you need. You don't need big hooks, little hooks will do. Look how small these are, because the way the carp feed, they suck up the food to the back of their mouths, sort it out and then blow what they don't want out. This is when the hook sets itself, most of the time. Sometimes you've got to set it for them, but most of the time they hook themselves. That's why we use hair rigs. So there's no food on a hook when we're using hair rigs. Everything is on a hair, as you can see here. Little tiny hair. I call it hair because it's just a little bit of hanging off. I'll show you how to make them on a future video. And they're strong as well, because you can use what we call a knotless knot. So there's no weak link in it. It's totally knotless, but strong as anything. These are baiting needles, scissors, little tools we use for boilies and stuff. There is the first aid. We use that for carp. Once we've caught carp, we then get cotton bud, put some of the antiseptic on, put where we've got the hook out, any ulcers or anything on the carp, treat them before we return to the water. Some of the foods we use. We've got glizzies there, they're spicy ones. Obviously sweet corn, luncheon meat, spam, they work really well for carp. Then we come to boilies. We have thousands and thousands of different boilies in this country. Half of them I think are to catch anglers, not to catch carp. But anyway, providing they're round and the right size for you, you can put any flavourings you want with them. A good flavouring for the winter is actually Baileys. So if your wife, girlfriend's got Baileys, nick some, put it in a little tub like this and soak your boilies in the Baileys. Carp love alcohol. Here we got ground bait, more ground bait, pellets, boilies, pellets, etc. My rigs already made up in there. All the rig components I need are in here. Over here is my bite alarms. And look what come through the post. Thank you, Jody. Awesome. Can never have enough hater blockers. Three pairs there. Catapult or slingshot. This is what we call a funnel web. It's a web in. You can put these little tiny pellets in, fill them up, stick them on, and you can throw them really far out. So they're getting tiny bits of bait really, really long distances. All these little reels is what I use for catching things like perch, bream, roach, anything while I'm waiting for my carp to come along. Obviously my main reels are my rods, which are in the garage. I'll show you them another day. This is just a little short, bit of reading material if you get bored. That's what I carry in my bag, my main bag. I've got another two bags full sorts of stuff in. It's ridiculous stuff. The amount of stuff we carry is ridiculous. But there we go. Anyway, that's a short to show you. Keep the channel going. So I'll see you all again very soon. Hopefully you'll be on the bank. Goodbye. Love yous. Bye bye.